Hi everyone, this is TaskForce Animation Engine, and when you open it, it's ready to play. I created some text blocks. Just select the text layers and click on the Animate button. TaskForce split and animate the text from bottom to top using 9 different styles, each style with its own options. I can also sync the animations with an audio track. Just enable and select the track, switch to audio here, and load. To be sure the sync speed is balanced, better to tick Speed Drives Audio Sync and increase the speed a bit. Animate. It's a very basic quick start, but there is a lot more. So, in the comp, I got some text blocks. The script animates starting from the bottom layer and ending to the top one. Here, I choose the way TaskForce split text. Let's start with words only. As you see, the script separates each text block into single words. Let's try rows only. Animation separated by rows, as expected. Then rows and words, which generate animations separated by rows and words randomly. Then paragraph, which shows the entire text block on each animation. And then I can mix all the split modes. And so I get row, row, paragraph, paragraph, paragraph again, some words, and finally row. What if I want to reset the animated text? Well, just click on the reset button here. The text blocks get back to their original state. Now let's try to modify this text from .com to .co.uk. Animate. As you see, the text got back to .com. This is not an issue. Reset the animation. After that, I can modify the source text, its position, size, and so on, and then reset again to update text. So, when I animate, it uses the updated text. In short, this button works as a reset button for animated text and update button for not animated text. Until now, all the animated text was centered in the comp. That's because the horizontal and vertical center checkboxes are on. If I untick them, the text is animated in its original comp position. Well, because TaskForce is all about fast cuts, I strongly recommend to center text to make it readable. Okay, reset and use just this text block. I want to show you the alignment tool, which is useful for text layout purpose. It let me align the anchor point. And if I set justification, it also justified text without moving it in the comp. Okay, let's get serious and talk about the animation styles here. The styles window shows all the 9 usable styles. Let's make it all visible. Each style can be active or not. Some styles can have options, and some can also have different directions to choose from based on the animation type. This checkbox makes me randomize the directions, and this one the options. When random modes are active, TaskForce choose directions and options automatically. The select button let me enable or disable all the styles at once. I start with slide style alone, and to make it simple, I also set the paragraph splitting animate. So I get only sliding text all the time, all from left to right, and each text block row is delayed. That's because I selected that direction and to delay. If I unselect the delay and I change the direction from right to left, now the sliding animations move from right to left and all the rows appear together. Okay, let's activate the zoom style. Because it's a zoom animation, the direction is from far to close. Now the script alternates the two selected styles. As you see, I set the paragraph, but all the zoomed text is split into rows. Why? Well, some animation styles, like zoom, don't give the perception of being fast if there is too much text on screen. So I decided to make them work with rows and words only. If you move the pointer to the style, you can read the supported split modes. In short, the first five styles support paragraph, and the last four don't. Remember, when you open the script, by default it is set to work using all the styles, all the options on, and random directions. TextForce is ready to run fully automatic. The override section here make TextForce animate each text layer using exactly the style and split mode I want. For example, select the first text layer and set it to slide. The slide marker is set. Set mask slide on the second layer, and so on. I'm gonna set a different style for each layer, so I can show you all. Okay, animate. So, this is slide, mask slide, track slide, blink, flash off, ping pong, zoom, hyper zoom, and tape writer. Each paragraph matches the set style. Let's reset, and you see the markers are not erased. Of course, I can override also each layer split mode. So I assign paragraph to the first layer, rows to the second, paragraph to the third, and so on. I got a P marker for paragraph, R for rows, and W for words. Look, slide by paragraph, mask slide by rows, track slide by paragraph, blink is split by words, flash off by paragraph, ping pong by words, zoom by rows, hyper zoom by words, tape writer by rows. This is real full manual control over animations. Reset. Of course, I can remove the styles markers and also the split markers. Now TextForce is back to auto mode. Now let's talk about speed and duration. By default, the script is set to speed at 100%. To make you understand, I select rows split and slide style only, so I have a precise reference. Animate. The animation ends here. I put marker just to have a reference. I set the speed to 130%. Animate. As you see, the animation lasts less. In fact, it is faster. On the opposite, if I set the speed to 70%, the animation lasts more. In fact, it is going to be much slower. To sync audio in TextForce, I switch from speed to audio here. Let's enable the audio track and listen. Rock and roll. Okay, load the selected track. The script generates all the peaks markers. I animate with rows splitting and slide style as before. The text is synced with the audio markers. Of course, there are too many markers here. To fix that, I can edit the audio markers here. I can manually edit the markers, but the smartest way is the threshold. I set an higher threshold value, like 11, and I click on Generate. TextForce raises markers closer than 11 frames to each other. Animate again and listen. It's all good, but the starting point. So I move the time bar here and I delete the marker closer to the time bar. I can also add or move the markers closer to the time bar. I can also remove all the markers, but well, undo. I'll show you it later. Get back to the show. Animate again. Much better. To make the sync perfect, I set a small delay, just a couple of frames. The markers will move back in time and cut start a bit earlier. Animate. Perfect. If I want to use a new audio track, in order to do that, I need to unload the previous track first here. Now I can load the interval track. Listen. Good vibes. Let's animate. As you see, the sync needs some work. Well, this time I will try a different approach. I'm gonna remove all the markers and I switch to interval. The interval method needs just two markers. Zoom a bit and find the in audio bit. Here it is. I set it. And here it is the out bit set. When I'm done, I generate. All the markers are set by repeating in time the base bit interval I set. Animate. It must be anticipated by 3 frames, I guess. Animate again. Very well. So, just remember, interval works very well when the drum bass is linear and consistent. Let's listen. This audio track has very fast beat. Okay, load the new audio, and I got a lot of markers indeed. Make it harder, let's switch to rows and words, and use all the 9 styles, and randomize the options too. Animate. So, because of the fast beat, the text is really difficult to read. Well, in cases such as these, I want to enable speed drives audio sync option. As you see, the speed controls are live again. This option generates every animation based on the specified speed, which makes text reading very balanced, and after that, it adjusts the cuts in order to sync each animation and to the closest marker in time. Because it's so fast, I set the speed to 125%. Let's see how it works. overall animation lasts more because it is not based on the ratio one marker, one cut anymore, but it is seeing and it's readable too. Well, that's all guys. If you like the tool, please suggest me some new fast cool animation styles. I will have a look and if it's worth it, I will be happy to include them in a future update. Cheers!